Colonel Bai.
It's Thursday, May 20th.
I'm Nazif.
And I'm Samia.
And here are your morning announcements. Everyone is invited for this year's Black Student Forum. The theme is resistance and resilience, moving forward with vision. The event is happening on May 27th from 10 to 2. For more details, visit ocdsb.ca/blackstudentforum for more details.
Are you still interested in taking part of Relay for Life this year? OCVSS is organizing a virtual Relay for Life for all OCDSB students on May 28th from 2 to 4 p.m. Visit our CB website under News for more details.
Next year's club registration is now open. Head over to the CB website and fill out the registration form to register your club.
Attention all grads. Don't forget to send in your baby recreation pics to the email below by May 31st. Send in a baby picture of you as well as the recreation. Speaking of which, let's go check out an ad on that.
I hear the drums echoing tonight. She hears only whispers of some quiet conversation.
Don't forget to send in those pictures, grads.
Are you interested in signing up for summer school? Head over to the CB Guidance website and fill out the registration form to sign up. The due date to sign up is May 21st for those interested in co-op and mid-June for all other programs. Make sure to sign up, Cougars, and it's on a first-come, first-served basis, so make sure to do it as soon as possible.
The 2021-2022 course changes form is now available. Please keep in mind that only changes to essential pathway courses are being considered right now. Elective changes are unlikely due to space and timetable limitations. Note that not all requests will be possible. If you have any questions, email your guidance counselor.
Victoria Day is coming up. Let's go see its history and how it came to be.
This weekend is a long weekend, but this day off of school has more history than many people realize. So, why is Victoria Day so important? Originally, this holiday used to take place every year on the 24th, which is also Queen Victoria's birthday. It has been observed since 1845 and was made an official holiday in Canada in 1901, the same year the Queen died. This holiday was then moved to be the Monday before the 25th every year in 1952. Queen Victoria was born in 1819 and became Queen of Britain at age 18 in 1837. Her reign lasted 64 years and was the longest one before the current Queen, Queen Elizabeth. Her time as Queen is heavily associated with the British industrial expansion and the British Empire during the 19th century. Her reign saw very important technological advances such as the typewriters, sewing machines, telephones, x-rays, and more. She was also Queen at the time that Canada gained independence from the UK, and she was the one who chose Ottawa as the capital. During her reign, the British Empire expanded to countries like New Zealand and various parts of Africa, such as Egypt and South Africa, despite wars, riots, and uprisings by countries trying to seek independence, like India. This holiday is now used to remember the great technological advancements made during Queen Victoria's time as Queen.
Wow, that's really interesting. I'm definitely going to be going out and getting some fresh air that day.
Me too. Hey Cougars, looking for a way to show our CB's teachers and staff some appreciation for their commitment during this unprecedented year? Well, the Bay Reach Thank You Card Initiative is just what you're looking for. You will be sending out the thank you cards as well as donating to the CHEO Foundation. Let's go check out how Nafis is doing with all this.
Oh boy, I just got my test back. I hope I at least pass. Please, please. Okay, wait. Let's go! Oh my goodness, I cannot believe I aced that test. I'm literally so happy right now. After taking L after L, your boy finally cut a big W in his math test. Now, there must be a way to let my teacher know how grateful I am. Should I write a song saying thank you? Or maybe send in a box of chocolates. Or just dap on my teacher, because we have this really cool handshake. Wait, never mind, there's still Corona. False alarm, guys, never mind. I got it. With my enhanced artistic skill, I'm gonna make the best thank you greeting card. Okay, we are all finished. Time to show the card to my boy Nazif, see what he thinks, and send it out.
Yo, what's good, Nafiz? How you doing, bro? How'd you do on that test?
You won't believe it. I actually secured that 4+.
Let's go. That's a dub. Good job, man.
Of course. Yo, let me show you something. Hold on. I made this for the teacher. What do you think?
Bro, I'm gonna be really honest with you, Chief. That's the worst thing I've ever seen, bro. How do you spell thank you wrong? How do you even pass English? How are you making these mistakes? You gotta redo that. Actually, better yet.
Okay, I get it, bro. I just wanted to send something nice, you know, to show my appreciation.
Listen to this. CB's Bay Reach is doing a thank you initiative for all the teachers, so you can send thank you letters from them to your teachers.
Wait, actually?
Yeah, don't worry, bro. They already hooked you up with the best templates, bro. It looks a lot nicer than what you made. And that's not all, bro. For every submission, they're gonna donate from $3 to $5 to the Chio Foundation. That's pretty sick.
That's actually even better, bro. Respect. I'm gonna check it out right now. Thank you, bro.
Well, I'm glad I was able to point Nafiz out to the right place. Make sure to submit your cards to Allison Kwan or submit them to the assignment on the Google Classroom. If you have any questions or need detailed instructions, head over to the CB Bay Reach Instagram page. Remember, CB, there is no limit to how many cards you can write. So, get to writing, Cougars.
Well, that's all from us today, Cougars.
To Cohort 8 and be at home, have a Toys R Us Thursday.